We are here nearly 7 months since the tragic loss of Columbia, and our efforts, the intent of our report, and all of the many hours that we put into this investigation were done to reflect favorably and to reflect with honor on the efforts of the crew, Rick Husband, Willie McCool, Mike Anderson, Dave Brown, Casey Chawa, Laurel Clark, and Elon Ramon. The lives of these people are very precious to us. The board considered that a very serious matter, that these brave people thought that what they were doing was important, that it was significant, that it was part of human space exploration, that the things that were going to be learned from this mission were worth the risk that they were taking. And if this board has any impact whatsoever, we felt that their loss of their lives had better make a difference. Thank you very much. Mr. Hubbard.
Thank you. In four simple words, the foam did it. After a lot of analysis, after a series of tests, we concluded that the falling foam impacting the leading edge of the wing was the cause of the breach that ultimately led to the destruction of the orbiter and the loss of the crew. All of this exhaustive work that we've done, all the discussion and the testing led us to the simple statement, the foam resulted in the breach that led to the loss of the orbiter.
We saw this piece of debris drop off. It looked to us like it impacted the orbiter on the left wing. We spent a goodly amount of time reviewing that film and then analyzing what that potential impact of debris on the wing might do, and would there be any consequences. It was judged that that event did not represent a safety concern. We were not concerned with Columbia. We felt we had analyzed that. It did not represent a control issue or a safety of flight issue. We have no information that would say that is not the case.
There was a very strong sense that we knew what happened. There's no way foam could have damaged the leading edge. And when they shot that piece of foam through that leading edge, that changed everything in the minds of those senior leaders.
I would say there were two causes to the accident. The first cause was the foam. The second was the loss within NASA of its system of checks and balances.